Right. Oh, Henry Bennett just patted him on the shoulder, folks. Henry Bennett, he's a jinx. Is the timer ready? Judges, are y'all ready? All right, whenever you're ready, Barney, you can do the start. I'm ready. Let's go.
Are you ready? You all set? On your mark. Get set.
Go. There it is. Time starts. So Rama skipped the whole station, so she's going to run all the way back there. She's got to run all the way back to Ernest T. Bass and get the rhythm. Come on, Ernest T. Get the rhythm.
Well, that's
credit
here.
So
now we're here.
Let's go, Ernest T. You got to do everybody the same or they'll be different delivery. Well, that's true. That was a delay penalty. Well, now she's getting back in the car. Yeah, switching back. Well, you know, she didn't get in out of the car twice. I'm not sure about that. Yeah, I'm not sure how that's working. She's running back there. There she sat down. Okay, there we go. Running back there. Switch out the pickles here at Operation Pickle Switch. There she goes. Oh, I don't know about this. Heading over down to... I'm moving. And now heading over to Gower to deliver some clothing items there for his date with Mary Grace. And she has a purple towel and apron on it to give to him. And Jill's doing a good job. Jill's running all over the place. This is a lot of running.
Henry touched him on the shoulder before they took off.
That's probably why he missed Ernest T. Wasn't
it? That's right. Now, I mean, the result is clear at this point. Do not get near Henry Bennett.
All right, so now Jill's at Weaver's department store. She's pumping up a balloon, I believe. Now, this is going to be the deal for... Oh, she's chewing gum first there. She's getting the chewing gum. She's got to chew some gum and blow up a balloon. Those balloons are hard to blow up, aren't they?
Yeah, they are. I'm going to kill Jeff Coons.
You been there for blow up balloons?
Did he come up with this?
There she goes. Now, she also has to successfully tie off the balloon so the air doesn't leak out. And then she can get back in the car and go... All right, she's done. All right. There you are. Good job. Now heading back over to Floyd's barbershop. She's going to splash a little witch hazel on her face. There you are. Back in the car. Now she's got to go over to the Golden Door of Good Fellowship with Howard Sprague. Howard, does your mother know you're playing poker? Yeah, so now she's... got to deal a hand of poker to him. Five cards. They don't actually have to play poker. She's just got to deal the hand. Yes. Now, coming up here to the finish line. Timers are watching for this. She's got to come over. She's got to jump out. She's got to put on the judo uniform. And then take the board. Here she's putting on the top. Put that on. She's looking in the book to see how to do it. Ah, time! There you are. All right. That's our first contestants. They're from West Frankfort, Illinois. Good job.
And if you'll come back after
the second. Yeah, right there. Got your lucky socks on and everything. There you go. Good job. Pat him on the shoulder. Yeah, every driver has to get patted by Henry now. All right, we're ready. Tyler, are you ready? Hey!
Thank you so much.
What are you doing? You're gonna... Oh, man, look at that. Tempting fate. Gave Henry a hug. All right.
I went to the next one. I was dripping off my...
On your mark!
It's a little much, Bill.
Get set! Go! Look at him speed out of there. That was amazing. All right. Stopping there with Ernest T. Bass at Mrs. Wiley's tea party. She's got to get out and get the rhythm. Look at the speed she's going. Oh, she's curtsying and everything. She's got the rhythm. Ernest T.'s declared it. She don't even want to leave. She's enjoying it so much. You know what? Yeah, let that girl go, Ernest T. All right, so she's heading back to the car. Now heading over for Operation Pickle Switch. She's got to switch out the 8B's bad old pickles for some good old store-bought pickles. Now, the Colemans are from Chillicothe, Ohio, by the way. Yeah, there she goes with her pickles. She's just taking a leisurely stroll after that, after the Shelby's there. All right, so Gomer's down here. He's already got his tie on. That looks nice, Gomer. Isn't that nice? So she's reaching out. She's got some brown shoes. Well, you don't have to put them on for her. She's even putting on the shoes for him. Look at that.
Well, one of them.
All right, so Pat's heading back to the car to head over to Weaver's department store. She's got a piece of chewing gum and blow up the balloons. Because they're having free. Free balloons and chewing gum for the kids today.
We have,
so here they go.
To go to in December,
she's,
where we
went to Georgia. She's taking her time getting her chewing gum. There she is. There. Now she's got to blow up the balloon. Oh man, she blew it up big, tying it off, make sure the air doesn't get out. She's good. There they are.
Met all these nice people.
Heading over to Weaver's Department Store to blow up the balloon, or to splash witch hazel.
And it's just a lot of fun.
Yeah. Henry, they seem to not be jinxed by you so far, Henry.
Yes,
sir. That's what I heard, anyway. Yeah, jinx.
Another benefit of it is.
Oh, all right. She splashes some witch hazel on her face. Isn't that nice? Yeah. Oh, she's there. Oh, they're doing. Hopping back in the car. She has on her lucky socks. I don't know if y'all noticed that. They're orange and blue Mayberry colors. The Golden Door, good fellowship. Howard, what are you drinking over there? Yeah. You got to deal him a hand of poker?
Right in our car. We've been doing it.
I don't know. They seem to be going a little slow. What do you think? I don't know if that's going to be enough. I don't think so either. I think they're going far behind the penalizer. I think she's actually playing. As she's getting back in the car. All right, here they go. Spilling out of there. Look at speed. Speed, speed, speed. All right, so they're at the judo place there. Got to put on the judo goat. Now she's hurrying. Now she's going to read the judo book, see how to do this, and going to break a board. Time. No, she didn't break it. Time. There it is. All right. Woo! Let's give him a hand there, folks. All right, so what's the time on this one? 3 minutes, 32 seconds.
Boyd, I don't know about this vehicle here. Are these not supposed to be American cars?
Well, most of them.
Yeah, well, his siren is Italian.
I don't know.
That's a sireno. Probably blows with an accent. Look where the hubcap is. Well, I guess we're good to go.
So this car is Todd Beckett. Where is Todd? Yeah. There you are, here.
Way to go, Henry. Stay on that side. Okay, Italian boy. Get on your bike! Get set! Go!
This guy here, he's
buddy! This is Ron Sippin.
Oh, look at
he's getting ripped up about his team. Here we are, getting back in the car now.
That's good dancing on the stage.
I say, hopping out here and heading to I'll place the pickle switch. Now, Ryan, please remember to go behind the car because the drivers can't be trusted. All right, get in there and switch out his pickles. Oh, he's moving there. Now he's heading around. Look at this. He's trying to run. What's he got?
Another tie?
Oh, he's got another purple tie. All right. He's back in the car. He's making good time, aren't
he? He is making good time. I don't think he's right.
No, he's not right. That's right. So this is Ron getting out. He's got a chew some chewing gum. And then he's gonna blow up a balloon. He's heading for the balloon blowing up. Oh, listen to him starting that motor. Oh, yeah. Well, look at that. All right, so he's got to tie off the balloon before he get back in the car.
No,
the air leaks out. It'll be too late for it. Oh, he's having a hard time tying this balloon. Look at that. This is the equalizer right here. Balloon tie. Let's cheer him on. Oh, come on. Gomer, how do you think he's doing down here?
How'd you do?
I'm not quite sure about that. Right. Oh, Henry Bennett just patted him on the shoulder, folks. Henry Bennett, he's a jinx.
He's a jinx.
Is the timer ready? Judges, are y'all ready?
Ready.
All right, whenever you're ready, Barney, you can do the start.
You ready?
I'm ready. Let's go.
Are you ready? You all set? On your mark, get set,
go! There it is. Time starts. So Robert skipped the whole station. So she's gonna have to run all the way back there. She's gotta run all the way back to Ernest T. Bass and get the rhythm. Come on, Ernest T. Get the rhythm.
Well, that's
credit.
Now we're here.
Let's go, Ernest T. You gotta do everybody the same, or they'll be different. Well, that's true. That was a delay penalty. Well, now she's getting back in the car. Yeah, the switch is there. Well, you know, she didn't get in and out of the car twice. I'm not sure about that. Yeah. I'm not sure how that's working. She's running back there. There she sat down. Okay, there we go. Running back there. Switch out the pickles here at Operation Pickle Switch. There she goes. Oh, I don't know about this. Heading over down to... I'm moving. And now heading over to Gomer to deliver some clothing items here for his date with Mary Grace. And she has a purple tie with apron on it to give to him. And Jill's doing a good job. Jill's running all over the place. This is a lot of running.
Bennett touched him on the shoulder before they took off.
That's probably why he missed Ernest T. Wasn't
he? That's right. I mean, the result is clear at this point. Do not get near Henry Bennett.
All right, so now Jill's at Weaver's department store. She's pumping up a balloon, I believe. Oh, this is going to be the deal for. Oh, she's chewing gum first. There, she's getting the chewing gum. She's got to chew some gum and blow up a balloon. Those balloons are hard to blow up, aren't they?
Yeah, they are. I'm going to kill Jeff Coons.
You been there for blowing balloons?
Did he come up with this?
There she goes. Now she also has to successfully tie off the balloon so the air doesn't leak out. And then she can get back in the car and go. All right, she's done. All right. Give her, there you are. Good job. Now heading back over to Floyd's barbershop. She's going to splash a little witch hazel on her face. There you are. All right. Back in the car. Now she's got to go over to the Golden Door of Good Fellowship with Howard Sprague. Howard, does your mother know you're playing poker? Yeah, so now she's got to deal a hand of poker to him. Five cards. They don't actually have to play poker. She's just got to deal the hand. Yes. Now, coming up here to the finish line, timers are watching for this. She's got to come over. She's got to jump out. She's got to put on the judo uniform. And then pick the board. Here she's putting on the top to keep, put that on. She's looking in the book to see how to do it. Oh, time! There you are. All right. That's our first contestants. They're from West Frankfort, Illinois. Good job.
If you'll come back after the second.
Right there. Got your lucky socks on and everything. There you go. Good job. Pat him on the shoulder. Yeah, every driver has to get patted by Henry now. Hey, who ready? Tyler, are you ready? Hey. What are you doing? You're going to... Oh, man, look at that. Camden Bay gave Henry a hug. Hi.
I went to the next one. I was dripping off my...
On feet. Your mark. Get set. Go.
Look at him speed out of there. That was me. Stopping there with Ernest T. Bass at Mrs. Wiley's tea party. She's got to get out and get the rhythm. Look at the speed she's going. Oh, she's curtsy and everything. She's got the rhythm. Ernest T.'s declared it. She don't even want to leave. She's enjoying it so much. You know what? Yeah, let that girl go, Ernest T. All right, so she's heading back to the car. Now heading over for Operation Pickle Switch. She's got to switch out the 8-piece bad old pickles for some good old store-bought pickles. Now the Colemans are from Chillicothe, Ohio, by the way. Yeah, there she goes with her pickles. She's just taking a leisurely stroll after that, after the Shelby's there. All right, so Gomer's down here. He's already got his tie on. That looks nice, Gomer. Isn't that nice? So she's reaching out. She's got some brown shoes. You don't have to put them on for him. She's even putting on the shoes for him. Look at that.
Well, one of them.
All right, so Pat's heading back to the car to head over to Weaver's department store. She's got to chew a piece of chewing gum and blow up the balloons. Because they're having free,
parades, and we have
balloons and chewing gum for the kids today.
To go to, we have,
so here they go.
To go to in December, where we go to.
She's taking her time getting her chewing gum. There she is. Now she's got to blow up the balloon. Oh man, she blew it up big, tying it off, make sure the air doesn't get out. She's good. Here they are.
Met all these nice people.
Heading over to Weaver's Department Store to blow up the balloon, or to splash lit witch hazel.
And it's just a lot of fun.
Yeah. Henry, they seem to not be jinxed by you so far, Henry.
Yes, jinx.
That's what I heard, anyway. Yeah, jinx.
Another benefit of it is.
Oh, all right. She's splashing some witch hazel on her face. Isn't that nice? Yeah. Oh, she's good. Oh, they're good. Hopping back in the car. She has on her lucky socks. I don't know if y'all noticed that. They're orange and blue Mayberry colors. The Golden Door, good fellowship. Howard, what are you drinking over there? Yeah. You got to deal him a hand of poker?
Riding our car. We've been doing it.
I don't know, Ernest. They seem to be going a little slow. What do you think? I don't know if that's going to be enough. I don't think so either. I think they're going far behind the penalizer. I think she's actually playing. As she's getting back in the car. All right, here they go. Spilling out of there. Look at speed. Speed, speed, speed. All right, so they're at the judo place there. Got to put on the judo goat. Now she's hurrying. Here she's going to read the judo book, see how to do this, and going to break a board. Nope, she didn't break it. Time, there it is. All right. Woo, let's get behind there, folks. All right, so what's the time on this one? 3 minutes, 33 seconds. 3 minutes, 32 seconds.
I don't know about this vehicle here. Are these not supposed to be American cars?
Well, most of them.
Yeah, well, his siren is Italian.
I don't know
that.
That's
a sireno. Probably blows with an accent. Look where the hubcap is. Well, I guess we're good to go.
So this car is Todd Beckett. Where is Todd? Yeah. There you are. Here.
Way to go, Henry. Stay on that side. Okay, Italian boy. Get on your mark! Get set! Go!
This guy here, he's sick.
You all right, buddy? This is Roy Sippin.
Oh, look at
him. He's getting ripped up around his team. He's taking a car. Here we are, getting back in the car now. That's good dance about the state. I say, Tommy, now here and Henry, I'll place the pickle switch. Now, Ryan, please remember to go behind the car, because the drivers can't be trusted. All right, get in there and switch out his pickles. Oh, he's moving there. Now he's heading around. Look at this. He's running right. What's he got?
Another tie?
Another purple tie. All right. He's back in the car. He's making good time, buddy.
He is making good time. I don't think he's right.
No, he's not right. That's right. So this is Ron getting out. He's got to chew some chewing gum. And then he's going to blow up a balloon. He's heading for the balloons blowing up. Oh, listen, I'm starting that motor. Oh, well, look at that. All right, so he's got to tie off the balloon before he get back in the car.
No,
the air leaks out. It'll be too late for it. Oh, he's having a hard time tying this balloon. Look at that. This is the equalizer right here. Balloon tie. Oh, that's Chandler. Oh, it's taking him a while on this, too. His dexterity's not what it should be. He can't tie balloons or steel cars. Oh, look at the car. It's moving.
Oh, that's a deduct. He's got the door open.
That was some speed there. That was speed. Did you see that speed? That's speed.
I wasn't even sure he was in the car.
Just like Gilly Watkins.
Okay,
that's it. Up and down, getting the gear on. He's got it on. He's got to look up how to break this board. Right there. Oh, that was good. Marilyn, all right, she's getting, heading back to the car. So this is Marilyn and Walt. Walt's the driver, Marilyn. There you are.
Get her out of here.
They're from Johnston. They're from Johnstown, Pennsylvania. This is Walt and Marilyn in Cleveland. She's switching out the pickles. Making pretty good time so far, I believe. This is a pretty good run thus far. Now they're heading over to deliver an item of clothing there. This is the brown belt.
Woo!
It has 10 ties, a brown belt, and a couple of shoes, I think, down here. Oh, he just has one shoe. Yeah, all right, heading over to Weaver's to get some chewing gum and a balloon. Oh, overdrove the position a little bit, so she's got to run back. Alright, get the chewing gum out. Alright, it's moving slowly. You she's doing all right, but I believe, what do you think, Otis? How do you think this run's going?
They're as fast as my deliverer. Yeah.
Your deliver what?
Groceries.
Oh, groceries. All right. All right. All right, so this is definitely taking a lot of time right here. I think she's losing time on the balloons. She's tying up the balloon. Her time was real good until there. She got it tied. Yes, tied. All right. Back in the car and heading over to Weaver's, to Floyd's Barbershop from Weaver's. Hopping out to get some witch hazel to splash it on her face. There, got it splashed on, the lid's back on. Oh, did you see him reach over there and open the door for her to try to save some time? Wasn't that nice of him? Yeah. Now she's got to play a hand of poker with Howard. You got to deal 5 cards. That's what she's doing behind the sign, you can see.
She didn't shuffle.
Oh, she's moving slow now. She's gotten tired as she's gone through, I believe. Now heading over to the judo. Put on the judo uniform.
You don't file a protest? We lose by 5 seconds.
Yeah, she don't know inside from outside, but she's getting it on. There she is. Yeah, those are my arms. There you are. Oh, time. There you are. Oh! Our best time before that run was 2 minutes and 52 seconds.
They would have had it.
They would have had it. They would have had it. They don't have
it. All right, so their time, this was Mike Havlin driving the car, and John Lane as the runner. Mike's from Lowell, Indiana.
That may be the obstacle.
All right, so I guess that's legal. Look at this, Barney. They have a bullet on their antenna.
Oh, yeah, look at that. Okay, you ready? Get on your mark. Get set. Go.
Oh, no. Somebody in reverse and somebody kills it.
Sitting right
through. I thought it got shot at. There was that bullet on the top. Oh, she's getting her dance with her Steve. Got the rhythm. All right. Okay, so she's got to open the door to get back in the car. She's back in the car and heading over to the Operation Pickle Switch. Oh, there she goes. Yeah, we thought the antenna, that gun went off. There she switched the pickles. Good job. Now, heading over to the deliver some clothing item to... didn't get a complete stunt. She's going to have got some more yellow shots.
Good job, Connor.
Yeah, they got it. All right, Gabriel, what do you think?
Well, that's fair, him being a professional driver and all, you know. It's like Gomer, he's got their clutch plate, their clutch disc, clutch bearing, and they forgot to give it a good wash.
They forgot to give it a good wash.
Well, the engine is purring like a little cat. And I guess the cafes have a Chinese food today. Are y'all ready? Drivers, passenger to your position. Thank you, Henry. You've really helped a lot today. On your mark, get set, go!
And they're off. So this is obviously the Bayberry Cafe's squad car. You're beating. Oh, they all got the rhythm. Oh, there they're back in the car.
Okay.
Yeah, well, that was nice. All right, so he's hopped out. He parked a long way from the table that time, didn't he?
Yeah, that's right. That is not very good strategy.
Parked on a long way from the table for the pickle switch. Now they're heading over to deliver. I believe they have a shoe heading over to give the Gomer.
Hey,
brown shoe to give the Gomer.
Kicking our tin all day long.
Hey, that's for the car. So he can get in and out quick.
No, the door just won't close. Yeah. It keeps the door from actually falling off, right? Yeah, would you mind locking that door, buddy? Okay, folks, here we go. This is the last competitor. On your mark. Get set.
They're off. He's Corey's jumping out of the car there. He's going around to get it. Understand that? Oh, he was doing like high stepping. Oh, look at that. Henry's in the back seat just touching the car the whole time. Look at him going around the corner there to dig out those pickles. Look, if you look, he even has on his... He has on his blue socks with orange shoestrings.